When we have a problem, there's not always an obvious or easy solution. Sometimes in these situations, you have no choice but to get creative. You'd be amazed what people can dream up. Often it's the craziest sounding ideas that end up actually working the best. What we have here is crackpot ideas that nobody could ever take seriously. There's even the odd nugget of genius where you think, hey, that could actually work. A tomato robot, glitter bombs for your foes, a slinky. We want to blow your mind. Here are 15 of the craziest ideas that worked out fine.
It's a potato with me on the potato.
Number 15. Quantum invisibility cloak. Harry Potter pants will gag. The invisibility cloak is here. A quantum technology made cloth that can reflect a light wave around the person who wears it so it can make the person disappear. They're called metamaterials and reportedly function as invisibility cloaks and could be used to make fighter jets impossible to detect or soldiers actually disappear, or maybe wizards escape evil. Metamaterials, or supermaterials, are engineered to have a property that's not found in nature. They're created from assemblies of multiple elements fashioned from various metals or plastics. When light goes through this mysterious material, it disperses sideways and follows a certain path to reach the same point as if it didn't encounter any objects. So visually, it seems that the object inside has disappeared. Researchers made the cloak from glass as it is transparent and does not need to be impregnated with expensive nanotechnology, as human eyes are not sensitive to light's minute delay. The team hopes that one day the technology can be developed to ensure the objects cannot be seen from any angle, and they claim it could have important security, entertainment, and surveillance applications. And fighting evil. You want to know a little secret? If you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you'll have superpowers for the rest of your life. So what are you waiting for? Time to fly. Number 14. Tomaten. Japanese juice makers unveiled the Tomaten, a hands-free tomato machine, a humanoid-looking backpack that can be loaded with 6 mid-sized tomatoes to power runners through every race. It's a wearable robot that feeds you tomatoes while you run. Weighing in at 18 pounds, Tomaten can be worn as a tomato-headed backpack, and at the flip of a switch, it will grab a tomato with its metal arms, then swing them over your head and feed the juicy treat to you. Japan-based artistic studios, well known for their unusual musical instruments and other devices, designed the robot, and an inexplicably large amount of the red fruit were involved in the process. Now, we really like Tomaten. It looks awesome and seems like a great conversation starter with your running mates. But there's one thing that's still beyond my grasp. Why? Why would anyone want to bite into a tomato while they're running? Well, according to the designers, which claim to be Japan's largest supplier of ketchup and tomato juice, people taking part in the Tokyo Marathon really need this. A lighter version of the tomato robot, known as Petite Tomaten, is available as well. The petite version is also featuring a timer so that the runner isn't fed too many tomatoes in one go. Number 13. SpaceX's triple booster landing. The private space company has successfully landed a triple booster rocket on a barge floating in the Atlantic. The landing represented the 6th time SpaceX has successfully brought back that individual rocket booster, a record for the company. The booster is the bottom portion of the rocket that houses 9 of its engines, standing about 160 feet tall on its own. To date, SpaceX has landed rocket boosters 58 times and has reused boosters for 40 missions. Its current fleet of rockets are partially reusable, with the company aiming to land the boosters and recover each half of the nose cone after launches. Together, the booster and nose cone make up about 70% of the total cost of a new rocket. It's a pricey toy, however. The company prices its Falcon 9 rockets at upwards of $62 million per launch, although its leadership has said reusing rockets can bring launches down to below $30 million per launch. SpaceX is also developing a fully reusable rocket called Starship that it plans to use to replace its existing fleet. The company's competitors have remained skeptical of its claims of how much money it's saving by reusing rockets. SpaceX's competition uses expendable rockets, which break up in the ocean or atmosphere after each trip. Number 12, the Million Dollar Homepage. Alex, too, isn't really known for following the in crowd, but he was obsessed with one thing, making money, enough to pay his way through college. I had literally no money, and I was worried, he says. I just brainstormed this kind of crazy get-rich-quick scheme that then took on a life of its own.
I think I wrote down, how could I become a millionaire in 2 weeks? Like, I was being really silly.
In 4 months' time, word of the page has gone viral and it sold out. Two had achieved success, fame, and his first million. For most young people, that would mean taking on a part-time job or going to the bank. But not for him, a 21-year-old budding entrepreneur from Wiltshire, England, who created the million-dollar homepage and peddled internet advertisement space on it at $1 a pixel in 10 by 10 blocks. The purchasers of these pixel blocks provided tiny images to be displayed on them, a URL to which the images were linked, and a slogan to be displayed when hovering a cursor over the link. 1 month in, he had raked in $250,000 and was receiving 65,000 hits per day. By the end of October, he'd made 500 grand from more than 14,000 advertisers, ranging from rock bands to penis enlargement companies. The website became an internet phenomenon, and at the beginning of 2006, the final 1,000 pixels were put up for auction. The final tally was $1,037,100. Number 11. Ship Your Enemies Glitter. The founder of Ship Your Enemies Glitter, a single-purpose service that lets customers anonymously ship their enemies glitter, has sold his business for $85,000 less than 2 weeks after starting it. Why? Please stop buying this horrible glitter product. I'm sick of dealing with it, said Matthew Carpenter, a 22-year-old Australian who launched the site with little money and some well-written advertising copy. But a week later, he was swamped by orders, leading him to put the whole thing up for sale in an attempt to rid himself of what he described as a horrible product. In the 4 days Carpenter ran the site, he says he took more than $20,000 in sales, far beyond what he was expecting for a website launched as a bit of a joke. That's more than $21,000 in sales for a website which isn't even a month old. But he got fed up with the idea and listed the site for sale almost a week ago. The website received significant media coverage and was described as having received over 1.3 million visits and was mentioned on social media about 300,000 times within its first 24 hours. Carpenter was somewhat overwhelmed by the interest and removed the ability to order glitter after receiving thousands of requests from people wanting to glitter bomb their nemesis. Number 10. The Rideable Suitcase. Nothing's new about a suitcase with wheels, unless it's your ride. We're calling it the Shootcase because it looks like he literally mounted a suitcase to an electric scooter. A Chinese entrepreneur has patented an electric suitcase scooter that can travel up to 37 miles on a single charge, as fast as 12 miles per hour. The former farmer got the idea when he forgot his luggage on his way to the airport for a flight to the United States. The man, whose identity is unknown, reportedly spent 10 years developing his rideable suitcases, even though this suitcase is not exactly groundbreaking. You do have to hand it to this guy's originality. Nobody else thought of this idea and went with it before. And while we don't know what's in the actual suitcase, which we assume to be filled with a rechargeable battery, the suitcase scooter does come equipped with a GPS system. Could we be on the verge of a new industry in DIY? Smug suitcase scooter vehicles? What do you think? Could you see yourself riding a suitcase to beat rush hour traffic? Now you'll have a shorter commute. Always know where your stuff is, never miss tight connections, and it can resolve all your everyday scheduling speed bumps that lead to horrible travel experiences and reshape your day into a smooth ride. Number 9. The Potato Parcel. This business is an unlikely one. Customers can order a potato with a message written for any occasion, from anniversaries to birthdays. From $14.99, you can send a potato pal, a potato topped with a photo of someone's face. The business, which appeared in a 2016 episode of ABC's Shark Tank and struck a deal, now employs 7 people full-time to create and sell the potato designs. Since airing on the show, Potato Parcel has sold over 70,000 potatoes. The idea came about when the then owner, Alex Craig, saw a post about someone mailing a potato with stamps on it. The post was so popular that in less than 4 hours, it had over 2 million views. He decided to take the concept a little further, adding customizable and anonymous messages to the mix. The company now sends unique, personalized messages, which have been written on potatoes, around the globe. The offerings range from gift boxes for $4.99 to the Potato Birthday Bundle, a potato with a custom message or image, and a birthday balloon or necklace. The bundle retails for $24.99. Craig sold the company to Riyadh Beckett before their appearance on the show, asking Beckett for only $1 in royalties for each potato sold for 60 days after the appearance. Number 8. Real Life Gundam. Masaki Nagumo has always dreamed of riding inside of a giant robot, just like the characters in his favorite anime series Gundam, one of the most popular franchises in Japan. So, he built one himself. The 44-year-old engineer built the Landwalker Mononofu, or LW Mononofu for short, a humanoid robot that stands nearly 30 feet tall and weighs over 7 tons. It contains a cockpit with monitors and levels for the pilot to control the robot's arms and legs. He can control the robot's arms and feet from inside of a cockpit, which is accessible only through a mechanical lift. The robot even comes equipped with an air gun that can shoot sponge balls at 86 miles per hour. "I think this can be turned into a business opportunity," he says, noting the popularity of the iconic Gundam series that has spawned movies, manga, video games, and more. The Japanese engineer has always dreamed of suiting up as a robot from Mobile Suit Gundam, his favorite obsession growing up. Now he's made it a reality by creating a giant humanoid inspired by the science fiction franchise. He works for a company that is a maker of farming machinery that also develops robots and other amusement machines. Renting the LW Mononofu or any of Nagumo's other robots costs about $930 an hour, but it's so worth it. Number 7. I Wear Your Shirt. I Wear Your Shirt was an advertising company that used t-shirts to advertise businesses. It allowed a company to buy a day in which founder Jason Zook wore a shirt adorned with the company's logo. He advertised for the companies by taking pictures and by uploading videos about the companies to popular streaming platforms and social media. For every day of the year, Sadler donned the shirt of a different company for a set price. On January 1st, the price was $1. At the end of the 365 days, Sadler's income would be $66,795. He received an additional $18,000 in from the sale of a monthly sponsorship. After factoring in the money gained from contests and other enterprises, Sadler's total income in 2009 was $83,000. He was inspired by the million-dollar homepage to create something that would be hopefully as successful and maybe down the road just as profitable. He noticed that for promotional purposes, many companies gave away t-shirts for free. Knowing that t-shirts caught people's attention, he decided to become a human billboard and create an advertising medium through free social media tools. The team created thousands of videos, 3,312 to be exact, photos, over 12,000, posts on social media, and had countless media outlets buzzing. Number 6. The Fliz Bike. In the crazy ways to get around category, the Fliz pedalless bike is certain to turn heads. The Fliz refers to the German word to whip or dash, flitzen, and it shares more in common with the hobby horse invented in 1817. Unlike on a bike, you have no gearing. This bike employs a harness system that the rider can hang from, rather than sit on the frame. This makes the rider run to build up momentum before placing their feet on a set of treads located near the rear wheel. Like the hobby horse, this concept has no pedals and relies on the rider creating a scooting motion. This gives the occupant an opportunity to pace while traveling faster and further than normal. You're arched forward throughout the ride, hands resting on handlebars, and your head peering through the front of the glass and carbon fiber frame. It's designed for people around 6 feet tall, while the harness is bespoke built for each user and has a quick release system with a 5-point fastener. However, despite appearances, there may actually be a genuine use for the concept. With no pressure on the joints and body weight, distributed over a wide area, Fliz claims that the bike could be used as a form of rehabilitation and exercise therapy. allowing those with restricted movement to enjoy the freedom of the bicycle. Number 5. Real-life hover bike. What do you do when you get bored? Maybe inventing is your thing. Plumber-turned-inventor Colin Frisee has made some pretty amazing creations, and his new hover bike is no exception. He created his cool new ride over a few weeks in his garden shed. So let's sum it up. You can control forwards, backwards with your weight distribution. It's not fighter jet responses, but it works. And side to side can come from placing more weight on either foot. Anyone who could ride flatland and do hitchhikers will understand this. But all this is very hard when the machine gets into a spin, which happens when the engines are not running at the same speed. By strapping a couple of two-stroke parajet motors and propellers to a metal frame, Colin built a DIY hover bike. The only thing he was planning to add was a small EDF engine on the rear to act as a tail rotor to stop the spin. To clear up a few other points, the rear prop is a mirrored version of the front, which Helix made especially for it. Weight is a huge factor. Even taking keys out of pocket and fuel tank being half full makes a noticeable difference, so no room for a co-pilot. Number 4. Kid builds a roller coaster. Backyard roller coaster? Yes, please. This bored teenager built a roller coaster in his own backyard. Logan Moore, 16, was inspired after spotting some scrap wood and piping in his backyard. The Kentucky schoolboy spent 2 months working on the one-man wooden coaster over the summer break. Logan, who wants to be an engineer, said he even has let his friends have a go and said the ride is a lot of fun. I took a class in carpentry class in school and I immediately fell in love with it. He built the ride completely by himself, putting in 15-hour days over this holiday to finish it. The roller coaster is pulled up to the tallest point on the ride, an 8.5-foot hill, by a motorized winch connected to a car battery. Its top speed is 13 miles per hour. Impressive, he continues. This is the second coaster I've built. The first one was smaller and I didn't like it, so I tore it down and started again. I like this one a lot more. It was hard at some points and it was time consuming, but it really is amazing. Logan's mom, Kathy, added, I have to say tears filled my eyes when he finished this coaster. I was so proud and happy for him. His hard work and dedication to this has been amazing. Number 3. Mr. Robot's incredible inventions. The sight of a farmer being pulled along in a cart by a walking robot would stop most people in their tracks, but Mr. Wu Yulu's neighbors on the outskirts of Beijing are used to the spectacle. The 48-year-old has achieved worldwide fame after inventing and building 47 robots in his backyard out of scrap metal. They can perform functions as varied as jumping, painting, drinking, massaging, and of course, pulling carts. He started his unusual hobby in 1986 and has continued ever since despite taking on huge debts, being sprayed with battery acid and risking his marriage. His wife nearly left with their two sons after he burnt down the house. Robot making has been Mr. Yulu's lifelong obsession. He's been fascinated by the mechanics of movement since childhood and was eager to make machines that could walk like people. Today, he lives in a typical, large, red brick and tile courtyard farmhouse, but his yard is littered with bike parts, car batteries, bits of Barbie dolls, and several works in progress. Mr. Yulu has even admitted to loving his robots more than his own children. He calls his rickshaw robot his 32nd son and programmed the android to declare, "Wu Yulu is my dad. I take him out on the town." Number 2. DIY personal flying machine. Is this Swedish for common sense? A Swedish engineer has created an outrageous flying carpet. The $10,000 vertical takeoff and landing drone employs dozens of motors to lift the rider. Creator Axel Borg completed his first successful flight and recently uploaded footage of the contraption as it flies through the forest and navigates through the obstacles without a hitch. Most experts are skeptical these projects can overcome obstacles in a weight restriction and battery capacity that would be needed to successfully carry human passengers, none of which seems to bother our intrepid Swedish inventor. The rotor configuration appears to be much safer than previous incarnations of the inventor's quadcopter, which featured 8 spinning blades adjacent to the open cockpits. Nonetheless, the inventor isn't wearing a helmet or anything that could protect him from the whirling rotors. He said he declined to wear any serious protective gear in order to feel more free. He can be seen buzzing through the trees in this sun-dappled Swedish forest like something out of a Scandinavian fairy tale. Number 1. The Slinky. In 1943, a mechanical engineer was designing a device that the Navy could use to secure equipment and shipments on ships while they rocked at sea. As the story goes, he dropped the coiled wires he was tinkering with on the ground and watched them tumble end over end across the floor. After dropping the coil, he could have gotten up, frustrated, and chased after it without a second thought. But he, as inventors often do, had a second thought. Perhaps this would make a good toy. He went home and told his wife about his idea. In 1944, she scoured the dictionary for a fitting name, landing on Slinky, which means sleek and sinuous in movement or outline. Together with a $500 loan, Slinky hit store shelves. By the 1950s, the Slinky was a national sensation. It continued to grow in popularity with new products, such as Slinky trains and Slinky animals. Slinky Dog became very successful after appearing in the 1995 movie Toy Story. People have also found other uses for Slinkies. In the Vietnam War, soldiers discovered that a Slinky could be attached to a radio and thrown over a tree branch. This made it an effective antenna. So, the Slinky was inducted into the National Toy Hall of Fame in 2000. By 2008, over 250 million Slinkies had been sold. That's enough Slinkies to circle the Earth more than 150 times. Those were the 15 craziest ideas that worked out fine. Thanks for watching.